This news broadcast is about English and how I hate that language. I do not want to offend people who were grown up speaking English, because all people around me are my brothers and sisters, including my daughter. My daughter, she knows the dialects. She can talk British. She can copy it like a copycat. Lastly, I was on a terrace in the Orphan Street here in Arnhem, and a flock of young people came at our table and they started the conversation in perfectly American, with all the time like I'm saying, like I whatnot. They were having fun and it was without an accent. I even doubted if they were Dutch. They were Dutch. And sometimes in the conversation, it lasted about half an hour, I switched back to Dutch and asked her some serious questions. Let me not speak Dutch. And then we switched back to English, American English, because there was someone from Bolivia, a nice looking girl, too young for me, but I do not come to the bar to pick up girls. And I just watched the company. About Dutch. Dutch is a language which stems from India. It is a mixture of Pali and Sanskrit. For that reason, the languages in Europe are also called Indo-Europeans, like a combination of India and Europe. And if you know me, you should know that I really love curry. In Dutch, we do not make a distinction necessarily between him and her. It is a sexless language. The Swedes have a program to call any child S, meaning a het, it, and not her or she. We do not mind. In French, you have l'homme, meaning the man, le homme, and la femme. We the Dutch do not have that distinction. We speak about de man and de vrouw. Both being denounced with the, I do not know the term, I'm sorry, but with de, and not le et la, like the French do. This is not, it is not nice to speak in that manner. In Holland, in Dutch, we have the phrase jongens, meaning younger ones, jongens. It is used to to denounce younger people of a male, in the male way. So you have the term, you have a child who is a female and she is 16. You call her meisje. If you have a child who is 16 and he is male, and you call that child jongen. Apart from that, it is often used that female younger persons, you even older females, can say amongst each others, jongens, let's go. This has been by Hofstadter, the American author, Thingy Hofstadter. He knew about this phenomenon. Let's get back to English. What I hate the most of English is the phrase human being. That is a right out insult of I and I in the meaning of what Bob Marley meant. It is no good to speak about a human being, because there is no such thing. And for this I have to return to the Bible, and you may now pause the video and get some rooibos tea. No coffee, or maybe coffee. Pause the video and I will continue. In the beginning, God created us. And it took him 5 days to prepare the environment for us. And he created us to his image. That is the truth. De waarheid. Or else it is a no-go. There is only one reason to read the Bible. That is, if you do not do that, you will die. You have to accept that God has created us to his image, of their image. Take a pick. So we are being. We have the ability to be. if you do not believe me, buy an aquarium, put a goldfish in the aquarium, feed him every day, and the fish will believe that he is in heaven. Because the fish does not realize that he is only swimming around in a goldfish aquarium and making the same rounds every day. This is not for us. Unless you are stupid. If you are stupid, then there is nothing the matter. Like Jesus said, blessed are those in the Sermon of the Mount. I'm not going to look this up now. I'm not going to check it for you. But the Sermon on the Mount. The Berg. Berg is a mount. Berge. Auf Deutsch. And the Sermon is the reden, the reason. Blessed are those who are stupid. We in Dutch do not talk about human being. We have the word mens. And I will explain, but bear with me. Human, hu, is a nasty sound. Here in Holland, we say, die Niederlande, the Netherlands, ho, you only tell to a horse. Ho and hu means stop. Human. Who invented that term? I really don't know why you should invent that term. Because we had the term mens. And it spells M, so Mayday, and then E, Edward, N, like not, S, like Simon. Mens. And the meaning of that word is the ability to think. Like, I'm sorry, but I'd like to use like in John chapter 1, verse 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. But for the time that you can speak, you have to be able to speak. And the ability to speak, it was given to you such as it was given to me. If you are a dog or a crocodile listening to this broadcast, yeah, go and do something else. But if you are a mens, then you can understand me. And a human, okay, I was a bit distracted just that about the word understand. It is a strange word. We have here the word verstaan. to stand up and not to understand. Begrief, I grab you. That is what we say here in Holland, in Dutch. I grab you. I take hold of you. Ich begrieve dir. Ik begrijp je. Ik grijp je. Back to the concept of mens. It stems from the concept manas, the ability to think, asali, from sa, Pali and Sanskrit, sorry. And we make a distinction between mens and man. A man is a mens who really thinks. Have you ever met really stupid people? These people that you met in those days, they were not men in those days. Maybe nowadays they are better and becoming man, like using your ability to think, then you are a man. And back to the concept of understand. Okay, to understand means to stand under someone else. Why should you do that? There is this phrase in Dutch, and it's called Did you hear that? You talk to your child, and your child just says Then it's okay. Why should you understand? There's no reason for that. And then to the big, terrible story that has come to my ears about the moon landing. And you, of course, are asking me why does Perry begins about the moon landing while speaking about that he does not like Latin infected languages. For which I make an exception for German, because it is still closely related to Dutch. And for the rest, Norwegian is okay, Swedish seems to me like gibberish, the upper Finland is also nothing, Hungarian, these people, but back to English. The moon landing. Going to the moon. What does that mean? In Dutch, it means going to a place where you do not want to be. So, if John F. Kennedy was a Dutchman, and he would have said in the beginning of the 1960s, between now and 10 years, I want us to go to a place where we don't want to be. if he was a Dutchman, the whole silly project with Stanley Kubrick and all those faked images and all those useless hours spent on chasing people like the first astronaut and putting them on YouTube and showing everybody that the moon landings were a fake, what is this for useless time spending? And we the Dutch, we would have known that on forehand. Why should you go to the moon? Is there a snacktaria? Like a sushi bar? Like a really beautiful women? We would have never done that. And now the really sorry story. When the colonies, when we, who are zachtmoedig, we are meek, we are courageous, but not aggressive, We, the courageous and non-aggressive people, when we fled, chased by the papacy, when we went to South Africa, and there we could pertain our language, sustain it. In America, there was a vote, a council, about what language should we speak formally, federally. What language should we choose? And that became English. And it is said that it was a German who put in the last vote and it became English. That is why we went to the moon. Any idea what it has cost to go to the moon? And what did we get back from the moon? Lovely ladies? Palm trees? Or just rocks? And you can find rocks all over the place. Go for the Gobi Desert, then you can find some rocks also. Now, thank you very much for listening to this broadcast, and I'm going to think what else I can pee you off with. You English speaking Turks. I'm just kidding. It was a joke from Blackadder. Well, not everything produced by the English speaking, the Latin speaking people is evil. Of course not. And that you have been grown up speaking English with this funny things like a human being and whatever, like what not, essentially, basically, I would like to say that if you mind, I would take over babberish, gibberish. Oh, and the last one, let me finish with Shakespeare. It's going to be fun. How it evolved, language. How language evolved. Here in Holland, we have a territory, it's called Friesland. And there they call the stuff that you call cheese. Say cheese! Cause we say kaas. In Friesland, they call it chis, which sounds familiar with the word cheese, don't it? So you had in Albion, the isles left from to the left to the west of Holland, on the isles, they spoke a lot of languages, dialects. And then there came this project, named by this author called William Shakespeare. Shakespeare is an image. The name Shakespeare, like in the Hebrew alphabet, is the first letter, Aleph, meaning discipline. Shakespeare, this word means, it has an image, and it is an image of a, it is the goddess Athena, we say in Holland, shaking a spear. It is the female heading on. I have done the lighting for multiple performances of Romeo and Juliet. I know about this crap. Like we say here in Holland, I have been there with my nose above it. My nose could smell the stench, the ugly smell. There is this lovely phrase by William Shakespeare, and he was not a person. William Shakespeare was a team. It was a team set up to unite the different dialects under some kind of Latin doctrine, like stupidity. The stupidity, Shakespeare, his target was to tell the people that they are really stupid. And meanwhile, to unite the different dialects, like Frisian. The stupidity, you can see that in Hamlet, where the protagonist, the main character, the big guy, Hamlet, namely, and he says, "Is this a dagger I see before me?" That is a sign of stupidity. Hamlet also could have said, when was the last time that the eyes in the back of my head still had, still worked? Or am I looking in a mirror? this could also be a case, be the case. I'm looking in front of me, I'm thinking I'm looking in front of me, before me, I think before me, but there is a mirror. Yeah, that could also be the case. Is that a dagger I see before me? Do you have eyes in your a-hole? Stupidity, anyone? And the other phrase. To be or not to be. How stupid can you be? What does he mean? To be or not to be? And I feel sorry for all your people who speak English. On the other hand, to make it good, the people who speak Dutch, about 90% are also as stupid as the hind, the backside of a pig. Pig. Varken. Tuurlijk, het helpt niet. Maar het helpt wel om Nederlands te leren. Oh, I'm sorry. I just spoke Dutch. But it helps to learn Dutch. It is a female, male-friendly language. Stand up and deliver and learn Dutch and see how easily with Dutch you can put your finger in the dike. No, that's not so that's not the thing I would want to say. You can, we call it prikken. To see the lie. Learn Dutch and you will see the lie. And still you can use the King James. Because we Dutch, we can speak any language. And how comes that? And the King James version van 1611, daar staat alles in. Daar kan je alles controleren. En jij gaat gewoon je Bijbel lezen. You are going to read your Bible. And thank you very much for listening to my rant on English. And als Hamburgs, like in Hamburgian language, als Hamburgs, sag ich, in the Hamburgianese language, I say, als Hamburgs, sag ich, tschüss, en dag lievers.